Hey guys, I want to let you know about this really cool thing that I found online, which kind of goes in line with the way I thought always that Archviz and virtual reality especially should be used. So I have a background in art history and architectural history. I have a degree in that. And so I've always been interested. I'm a 3D artist, but I've always been interested in just architectural history and art history in general. So I've always thought that those two things should be combined with each other. And especially when you go to visit ancient sites, I always think, wouldn't it be cool if we could walk through this in virtual reality the way it existed originally, right? I think that kind of stuff would be super cool. So we're not to that point yet. I mean, obviously the technology's there and people are working on those kind of things. I know someone's working on recreating the Roman Forum in 3D. Hopefully someday we'll be able to walk through the Roman Forum in virtual reality. I recently walked through the Titanic in virtual reality, which someone online is creating for a video game. That is absolutely awesome. But there's this other thing too, where they're going and documenting. Google is doing this in cooperation with this company called CyArk. And they have this open heritage project. And they're going around and actually documenting ancient sites, World Heritage sites. So this is awesome because they're using technologies like LiDAR and photo scanning to document the sites and create perfect 3D models of them. So you can't necessarily walk through them in VR. What this offers you here is like 360 degree panoramic views that you can click to and go to, which is cool. You can get in there and look in any direction, and there's photographs all around you, and you go to specific points. But I actually think it's way more immersive to be in there at human scale inside of the premium VR goggles like my HTC Vive, because this really makes you feel like you're standing there. So with a little bit of work, we can get there, and I think it's cool. So I downloaded a sample. Here, if you go to Arts and Culture, Google Arts and Culture, I typed in Open Heritage, that's the name of the project. And I went to the Chichen Itza 3D model here, which is a Mayan observatory, and it's pretty cool. So I saw one that was kind of small, and they, if you click on this, you can see that it takes you to a 3D model. Basically a 3D scan of that building. Okay, so how do you take this into VR? Well, you have to know a little bit about Unreal Engine, but if you do, then it's actually super easy. Okay, so it's better than just panning around like this. You can actually stand right there, look up at this thing, and then walk around as you please, which is awesome. So if you download this model, it gives you something like this. Okay, here it is in 3D Studio Max. Okay, so if you follow the normal steps to export into Unreal Engine, then you can take this model and get it into something that will work with virtual reality. I used the export Datasmith. Okay, Datasmith is the new tool that makes all this stuff very easy. Doesn't matter what kind of textures are there. If you look at the textures, it's completely unwrapped with tiny little photograph chunks placed all over that model. So it's cool. It's ready to go already. So if we go into our Epic Games Launcher, launch Unreal Engine. Okay, and here I'm not going to redo everything. I've already created this in VR, but all I did was go to new project. I went to standard VR virtual reality here, and then I converted to a Datasmith project so I could import Datasmith. Of course, you can do it as an FBX too. With this one, it doesn't really matter. But I open the basic VR thing, and if you don't know where to go from there, just check out some of my other videos about using the VR tutorial. But I followed those basic steps. I kind of deleted the things in there, placed my new model in there, and let's open it up and see what it looks like. Okay, so here I am just in the standard motion controller map. I deleted all the objects in here, all the cubes and stuff around. I imported my own object, and in fact, like I said, I didn't need to use Datasmith for this. I just exported using basic FBX, because this is all just a standard material, one material on a model, very easy to import. The material looks like that, which is totally crazy, but there it is. And then all I did was bring in the model, set up some lighting. I had to scale it, and the only downfall is I don't know exactly what scale this is at. I could go look that up and get this to the exact right size. I have not done that, so I scaled it up to something that looks basically write. And then my post-processing and my light mass volumes are both here in post-processing. Let's see, I turned on a little bit of fog to kind of make this bloom going on, the environmental fog, which is already there in the template. And I baked in some lighting, made the lighting just static and baked it in, with the sun coming from that direction off to my right. And then the only other thing I had to do was go into the static mesh here and add a collision, which you can see here, just this big box. And it isn't perfect because that ground isn't perfectly flat. So I could go in and be more careful about that if I want it to be more realistic, so that my VR character is always walking exactly on the ground. I did not do that. I could compute a very complicated convex collision over here to fit my object, or I could model a simplified collision box in 3ds Max and import it and use it as the collision here. But for now, I just put a box and we can walk around on top of that. The only thing to be aware of is to make sure that you put that collision box in there so that your navigation works. If you hit P, your navigation preview will come up, and wherever your navigation nav mesh bounds volume, which of course you can get over here and drag into your scene, wherever that box intersects with the collision on our observatory here, then you'll have navigation capabilities with the VR hand motion controllers. Okay, so that's really all it takes. Then you go to the VR preview, click on it, and here we are in VR. We've got let me show you one other thing. Default in the level is to have the VR pawn right here. So there he is, placed inside that doorway. That's where your player will start. And again, I've got tons of videos about the VR template if you want to learn about that. So let's hit play and check it out. It's really dark in here. The auto exposure is working though, so it's getting brighter. I'm going to get in my headset and walk around. Okay, I'm inside here. Here's my hands. Use my thumb pads to navigate around. You can look up and see some of the ruins that have eroded up there. We walk outside, got kind of this little moat going on around here. You can walk over to here, stand right on the ground. We can turn around. I think this is so cool. This gives you the scale. Let me stand up. This gives you the human scale of this place and makes you feel like you're there. I've never been there in person. I wish I had. But if I had, then I'd probably know this scale a little bit better. Here I am, reaching up to the top of the door. You can walk through here. And I don't even actually know if you can do this in person. I assume you can. Here's the stairs coming up to the observatory. And again, I could fix that collision to work better so I could actually walk up the stairs and get this approach right. But there it is. There's the observatory at Chichen Itza, and it's pretty awesome. As you guys probably know, the headsets are the most effective way of getting that human scale element and feeling like you are actually in the space, getting all the proportions set in your mind and feeling like you've really experienced the space. So in short, it's the most immersive experience as far as 3D goes that I have found. And so I think it's really cool that they make these models available, and with a few little steps, you can get them in VR and walk around. Now this is a small site, but they've got big sites all scanned in 3D too, that you can walk around and experience for yourself. So hopefully you have some fun with that and think it's cool. You can check out the link, and I'll let you have this little project here if you want to walk around in it. And of course, this model doesn't belong to me. It is a Creative Commons license, and it comes from CyArk. So go ahead and check that out, and thanks for watching.